So it's just past 9:30 on the evening of the 21st of March 2021, and it's been another wet, soggy day here in and around Sydney. Certainly not as wet as what they were projecting, and that is a good thing, because even though we are experiencing floods, and you know, in some parts records are being set, it could have been a lot worse. I think the projections for some of the rain in and around Penrith and Richmond didn't eventuate, and we are quite lucky in that regard. So we're looking here at, you know, the projected rainfall over the next 5 days, and I've just highlighted Warragamba Dam as the point of interest there. So over 100 mil still expected, and just looking at the northern extremity there, 132 mil on the southern, 110, and that's just on Warragamba Dam itself, and not, you know, any of the I guess rivers that feed in there. If we look, have a look as far north as Lithgow with the Cox River, you know, that's 100 mil. And then further south, you know, still 100 mil across the board, which equates to a very long and prolonged period of time for which water will be feeding into the dam. As I mentioned in the video on Saturday the 20th, the dam was tipping or spilling, and we've got some good footage here, which we'll might just play, because it's pretty stunning. Stunning the amount of volume that's coming through the gates there, just the power. Yes, and the ferocity. This is another interesting video just explaining how the gates work at Warragamba Dam.
Warragamba Dam is managed entirely as a water supply dam. During floods, the gates work automatically. The gates open and close based on water levels in the lake, a process called the H14 protocol. After heavy rainfall, when the lake rises above full supply level, the gates open in sequence, starting with the drum gate, then followed by the radial gates, which open in stages. As the water level rises more than 230 millimetres, the radial gates begin to open progressively from 4%, 9% and 13%. From this point, the outside two gates, 1 and 5, open first, followed by the inner two gates, 2 and 4, which open progressively from 27% until all gates are 100% open. When all gates are 100% open, the lake is 1.83 metres above the full supply level. When the lake level begins to drop, the gates close, following the same sequence in reverse. After a flood, the gates can be manually operated to reduce the level in the lake if this is needed for operational reasons. The gates on the dam, along with the auxiliary spillway, are designed to safely pass extreme floods, much larger than the worst flood on record for the Hawkesbury-Nepean Valley.
So one of the interesting things that they mentioned in the video there was the height of 1.83 metres. And the reason why that is of interest is if we actually have a look at the height of Warragamba Dam, we can see that, and it's probably better to actually have a look at it as a table, it didn't quite hit that. It got to 1.5 metres above the wall. So certainly not as bad in terms of volume being let out. And so we can see here it reached its peak early, okay, 152. Yep. So at about 4:50 this afternoon, and then it's been dropping slowly ever since. But you can see there that, you know, it's got at least, you know, a day to 2 days, assuming that the amount of water that it is letting out is not matched by the amount of water coming in. You know, going back and, you know, thinking about the slow flow of water from these regions that have had heavy rainfall and are still expected to have heavy rainfall in the coming days. So we also talked about some of the other dams located down here, you know, being the, you know, Nepean, Avon, Cordeaux and Cataract. So why don't we have a look at those in order? So Nepean has started spilling, and has tapered off, I guess, but still above the spill level. So I guess that means the amount of, you know, volume of water feeding in is not being met by the volume of water that's spilling over the front. So that's, I guess, you know, shows where there could be concerns. And all of this water is actually going to, you know, eventually meet up with the water spilling over the Warragamba Dam. Now, if we have a look at the Avon Dam, that has yet to spill, but looking at that trajectory, you know, it will start spilling, you know, probably sometime on Monday morning, you know, combining, you know, with the Nepean Dam's overflow. And if we have a look at the Cordeaux, that too is close to tipping, and I guess that trajectory shows that it will tip, you know, probably early tomorrow morning. Cataract Dam, again, you know, that trajectory to me indicates that it too will start tipping early on Monday morning. So again, just describing, you know, where this is going to flow, all these dams, you know, eventually feed into the Nepean River, and then, you know, pass, you know, the towns of Picton, Camden, and then eventually flow up here to meet up with the water coming from Warragamba Dam. So the flooding that's been experienced so far has been in the southern part of Penrith. I think this is the main areas. I haven't seen too much footage from there, but I definitely know that they've closed the bridge over to North Richmond, and I've seen pictures in and around Freeman's Reach, a lot of turf farms around here, a lot of small farms that supply produce to Sydney and the local areas are probably all underwater. which is quite sad, for those people who make a living from that. Talked in previous days around the fact that the Hawkesbury River at Windsor is tidal, and the next high tide is tomorrow morning about 9 o'clock in the morning. So you would expect that it would the most amount of damage would occur in and around that time. Maybe this is a good time to mention, this is where we've really dodged a bullet, because if we have a look at the maximum height there for the high tide is 1.2 meters, but it's certainly not the largest tide that we can have. So 1.7 meters the following Monday. So if we were a week later, the flooding would be significantly worse. So I feel that we've really dodged a bullet in that way. So we'll continue to track what's happening in and around the Hawkesbury Nepean Valley and the damage that's occurring there. We'll certainly keep an eye on the projected rainfall. We've got other systems coming in from the northwest of the state. We might just have a look at the that animation, which is always good to have a look at. So we can see so I think they're certainly worried with these systems moving towards the coast and then drenching already rather saturated areas. And that's a really interesting, like this band here. So how much is that? That's 30 mil every 3 hours. So that will pass, contribute to Warragamba Dam and the other dams for that matter. It's not until Wednesday until we start to see or have some respite from the wet weather. So I think I'll leave it there. It's certainly nervous times for people. Many people located out in and around Windsor, Richmond, Penrith, Picton, probably Camden as well. The good sort of point to mention here is that we haven't had any fatalities yet. I hope that remains. That people are not doing stupid things like crossing waterways, not knowing the depth of the water. I think that has certainly been the cause of many deaths in the past. So if we keep our heads and our wits about ourselves, we'll get through this without the loss of life, and I think that's the most important thing.